Hey guys, how's it going? We're on the play here. Yeah. I think I'm supposed to keep this pretty borderline. I almost never keep hands that don't have like lackey or vile, but we have a tar fire, so if the opponent plays like a turn one deathrite shaman or a delver or something, we can go like tar fire your thing, untap war marshal. If the opponent's playing like a sneak and show deck, like some kind of combo thing, then our hand is just way too slow. But if the opponent's trying to grind, then we're probably in okay shape. Like if we are facing some kind of Delver variant. Our build is actually terrible against sneak and show. Goblins usually has a reasonable sneak and show matchup, just because, especially black-based goblins, because you can play cards like Cabal Therapy and Red Elemental Blast, cards that are pretty good against show and tell. And when they play show and tell, you can like put a goblin matron into play and go like tutor up a way to deal with whatever they put into play, like stuff like that, and you can actually apply pressure. The problem is, I'm just gonna let this die. It's gonna Warchief, give the token haste anyway. I'm gonna stifle one time, please. Okay. Where was I? Oh yeah, the problem is show and tell decks aren't actually that common on Modo. Okay, yeah, we're facing a grindy deck, cool. This could even be Miracles. It's either blue, white, red, and tempo, and which would be a little bit weird because we haven't seen like a Delver or a Stoneforge Mystic or a Young Pyromancer or anything, or just actual Miracles. The basic is kind of implying it's just Miracles. They play a single Volcanic Island generally for the splash, so I'm just gonna matron. I don't think Warchiefing here makes that much sense. Just gonna matron up Ringleader. Get some gas flowing. Get in my damage. This cavern was pretty good. Going for the throat here would be like getting Pile Driver to go Warchief plus Pile Driver, but because we're not playing against a combo deck, there's no reason to do that. If we were playing against a combo deck, he wouldn't have had the plow for the Warchief, and we could have actually had a pretty explosive turn four here. Anyway, I'm just going to get Ringleader. Fight through some removal from the opponent. So we're in a pretty good position here. Like, he kind of needs to find a sweeper to deal with our garbage. Like, he's at 16. We're getting to the point where we have enough pressure, you know? Enough that he has to start thinking about doing something about it. What was that sentence that I just said? Getting to the point where we have enough pressure where he has to start thinking about doing something about that. Yeah, that's not a good sentence. Can I take that back? Can I get a rebuy on the words that just came out of my mouth? There's gotta be a better way to phrase that. Alright, attacking you for 5 or something. Something that I kind of like about goblins is some of the creatures are like just value based and tutor based, which is really sweet. And then they also already all have haste. So if the opponent is a factor fiction, this isn't Miracles at all. This is so much more exciting. Okay, I don't care if he has Force of Will. I'd like to give him Force of Will. I'd like to let's just actually just do this. Right? Like, I don't care about any of this. Like, the Force of Will and the Spell Snare are dead against the Cavern of Souls, so the split is actually just, like, Island, Brainstorm versus Snapcaster. And, I mean, this is chat that he can put back with Brainstorm, but I don't think I actually care about it. The Snapcaster rebuys Swords to Plowshares. I care about that a little bit more. Alright, 4-1 split. Running it. What do you want, man? Would you like to go up to 9 cards in hand? He would not. He would prefer to have a Snapcaster Mage. Do not blame you, sir. Pondering around. Okay. Yeah, fact or fiction's exciting. Oh my god. EOTFYF, you lose. Oh, Krinko. I think I'm just going to matron around. Like, just matron for another ringleader. Rather than, like, go war chief pile driver. Watch my war chief get plowed or whatever. Yeah, I'm just going to serve. See what he does. I'm actually wondering if I should Tarfire the Snapcaster, because the Snapcaster is just going to like go in front of a random Goblin Matron or whatever, and then if he is playing Stoneforge Mystic, I'd much rather hold on to the Tarfire to kill a more relevant threat. Yeah, I'm just gonna let this resolve. Yeah, if he goes Stoneforge Mystic for Batterskull, then we can go like Tarfire, he hardcasts Batterskull, we warn weird him or whatever. I think this is fine. Let him trade with a 1-1. Just gonna go matron for ringleader again. And hope to start hitting land drops. Hitting land drops would be great. Maybe I go second main phase war chief. Second main phase war chief pile driver. How bad is that? We should just play Krinko if that's the line. All right. Yeah, I think that's fine. It wouldn't be fine if we didn't already have these Goblin tokens in play, applying pressure. And like the Warchief has haste. Yeah, okay, sure. So we've burned through Swords to Plowshares, Snap, Swords to Plowshares, Swords to Plowshares. He's got 4 cards in hand currently. GTMS. Better than some? Better than an eggplant? What is Jace the Mind Sculptor better than? Choose one. Donuts? Question mark. Land. Yeah! A good land, too. I'm so excited. All right. I'll choose Goblin. I'm a risk taker. I'll make the weird plays like that. Alright. Wow, can we just attack with everything? So this by itself is 7, right? So, okay, cool. I was thinking, I'm pretty sure I send one of the Goblins at Jace there so I can finish it off with Tarfire if he's got something weird to stop me from winning. So I'm not sure if I like Blood Moon in this matchup. I think, because he was fetching out a few basics, like it could get him, it could just be bad. Kind of like the idea of Grafdigger's Cage. For like Snapcaster nonsense. If we had Rebs, that would be... That would be a pretty great sideboard card. I could also bring in Thoughtseize. I like the idea of Thoughtseize. +2 Thoughtseize, maybe minus Prospector. Prospector's pretty good against Stoneforge Mystic. We didn't actually see Stoneforge Mystic, though, so that's kind of a problem. We could just do -1 Warren Weirding. I kind of like that. The little switcheroony. Shave the Blood Moon, shave a Warren Weirding. +2 Thoughtseize. Seems good. Yeah, when we're not really sure what the opponent is doing, I think there's a really big risk to overboarding. Chalice wouldn't be the worst. It'd kind of be the worst. We got some one drops. And we're bringing in Thoughtseize, yeah. Yeah, I don't hate Grafdigger's Cage. How about this hand, huh? The Cavern's actually kind of good, but the rest of the hand is kind of garbage. It's, okay. Sure. Why wouldn't I want a Skirk Prospector? Oh my god, a Skirk Prospector. Why did I keep that thing? Why did I keep that terrible card on top of my library? Go into the Badlands. Yeah, we didn't see a Wasteland last game, and we saw a lot of the cards out of his deck, so I think fetching Badlands here is fine. Want to be able to cast a Thoughtseize if I draw one. Yeah, give me some of that land action. Not as good as Cavern, but you know, you take what you can get. Even if it's just a stupid basic mountain. Alright, take one. 19, tied game. Time to pile some drives. Woo! Man, this, this, the guy that Pile Driver is on top of is just not having a good day. He is just, he's like trying to bite the arm. He's like, oh man, he should not, not have gone into work that day. He looks miserable. All right, time to chief some wars, I guess. Rawr. Not spell snaring this one. Pretty glad I boarded out that Blood Moon. It seems absolutely atrocious in this matchup. Alright, give me a Cavern. Right off the top, short and sweet. Oh, okay, well. I'm just gonna do this again. Red mana. L Bolt. Man, this Skirk Prospector is getting in damage. I don't think it's correct to crack him in, or like sack him for Ringleader here. We're not going to just be playing Matron. Ooh, or a Goblin Chieftain. Joblin, Joblin, Joblin. Joblin up, Joblin now. Let's go. Attack him in your face. Oh my god, we got in damage. Yes! Yes! So satisfying. I'm not sure about this card. Is this a fact or fiction? Looks like a fact or fiction. Should I like Supreme Verdict Verse? Probably not, right? Definitely split the Supreme Verdict with the second white source. But like, just giving him Snapcaster and a pile of ponders means he can Snapcast back. A plow on my... that, so like, I kinda like this. It's not the best. Like, he gets an awesome pile either way. What did he keep? I didn't notice the cards in his hand. He kept the three pile. I guess I could just see the Supreme Verdict in his graveyard, huh? Okay. Oh man, we can like Warren Weirding our own creature to get two goblins to sack to the prospector, and then yeah, no, I'm not I'm not actually doing anything like that. I think I should be matroning, but I'm not sure what I should be matroning for. Something awesome. Another matron. Matron for matron. I would like another 1/1. Brainstorm in response. Sure, man. Storm of brains over the landscape. Actually not feeling the best about this game. My opponent has a ton of cards. We know that two of them are Snapcaster Ponder, and he didn't feel the need to ponder on his turn. He's also just firing off a brainstorm here, you know, like he's not playing the brainstorm with a shuffle effect. So if you're gonna brainstorm to look for like a Force of Will or whatever, Sure thing, boss. You should probably do it as a sorcery. I don't know. Maybe he didn't know if he wanted to counterspell or not. Because now he had to redraw one of the cards that he put back with Brainstorm. And he's still not shuffling. He just wanted all those cards. That's nuts. Give me that land. Ah. Alright. How much damage do you think he's going to take from this Prospector? Approximately all of it. 8 more attacks. Let's go. Let's go, buddy. Drive some piles, as you do. As you do. Oh no, who could have foreseen this terrible calamity? Snapcaster Mage, not the best blocker for Pile Driver, but if you're just snapcasting back Bolt. Oh, he's not. He's snapcasting back Factor Fiction. Man, I wonder if he's got like Main Deck Spirit of the Labyrinth. Probably not when he's playing Brainstorm Deck. But like, that would be a really good reason to be playing Factor Fiction as your draw engine. The Spirit of the Labyrinth. Don't give no ducks? Question mark. Rocking it. He seems like he has plenty of lands. So I basically just gave him Factor Fiction plus redundant land drops with that split. Okay, would you like to attack? Serve with that Snapcaster, I dare you. Please serve with the Snapcaster. No, he doesn't want to. That would be insane. Just like, well, he's not going to block with his 1-2. Serve with Snapcaster, just like, pro blue you. Yeah, people still miss that every once in a while. Just because it's really weird to have on the card, just like this rando pro blue. I think it was so that red could fight with Psychotog during the time period that Pile Driver came out. Because Tog was in the previous block, and it was very good. So I think Wizards R&D was like, I think we have to throw protection from blue on some random red creature that's already like pushed in power level to balance this nonsense. Jace, sure. Would you like to bounce my Skirk Prospector? He would. He would actually like to bounce my Skirk Prospector. He's taken enough damage. Would you like to ride in my beautiful Badoon? Alright. Odds on Ringleader resolving. Like zero. Diddle squat. Is diddle squat the technical term for not resolving? Is that what's going on here? Ring some leads. Let's go. That's a force of will. That's a thing that's happening. Opponent at 7. I think I'm supposed to do this. Cavern would have been so good. At least he didn't have actual counterspell. Hey, an actual counterspell. Maybe should have split that differently. Like, counterspell and Jace were the two best cards in the pack, so like putting them in separate piles is maybe correct instead of doing the 2-3. I think it's fine, though. Maybe bait counterspell on something irrelevant. His deck is the dirtiest thing I've ever seen. I don't know what his win condition is. I assume it's just Jace. I assume he's just got Jaces and Snapcasters, and that's how he's going to win the game. Because we, like, I think if he had Stoneforge Mystic, we would have seen it by now. I don't really want to Krenko into the counterspell. I'm just going to do this. Oh, maybe I should be weirding myself. That sounds so bad. Almost as bad as killing his irrelevant Snapcaster Mage. I think we're running low on gas, boys. When this is the play, when like Edict your irrelevant 2-1 is the play, then probably not winning this one. So game three, prioritizing. I mean, we got some damage in early. We had a curve. It was not the most intuitive thing to send that bank. But, yeah, Aether Vial or Cavern, definitely important. I'm kind of surprised to see this many counter spells in post-board. Yup. And we're dead. His hand right now is Counterspell, Backup Jace, three unknowns. Is playing Wasteland, but it seems like more of a utility card in his deck because he's three colors. So the Wasteland is probably just to hit cards like Academy Ruins, cards that are difficult for him to deal with. As opposed to like playing four Wastelands and trying to mana screw somebody. So what did he keep there? He kept the Wasteland Snapcaster. He's down to 14 cards in his library. At a certain point, Jace upticks are like not gonna be a viable win condition if he goes through enough cards. I could see like a Snapcast Brainstorm or Snapcast Bolt here. Hydro Blast, alright man. Hydro Blast is an actual good counterspell though. Because it's also a removal spell, like it deals with turn one Lackey. Lackey actually seems pretty not good against this deck. Like, it forces a removal spell, but he's got Bolt and Plows and Postboard Hydro Blasts. Like, it's just never doing a thing. This game's pretty over, but I'm kind of interested in seeing the rest of his deck. The remaining 16 cards, you know? Like, what's going on? So we killed two Snapcasters. Wastes my waste. You got it. That's a lot of mana. Okay, he is playing Batterskull. There's probably a Stoneforge Mystic or two in there then. Alright. We've successfully discovered a win condition. Yeah, I don't think Tuck Tuck Scrapper is worth it. Like, we have Warren Weirding to get the Batterskull off the table for a turn. We got like Thoughtseizes and stuff. I don't really think Tarfire and the Weirding are that good or worth it at all. Let's either Chalice or Grafdigger's Cage. I don't want to do both, but we could do one of them. I think Chalice on one is good. So we cut Prospector. Probably cut Tarfire. So this composition is kind of weak to Stoneforge Mystic, but we didn't, I mean, we saw a lot of cards and we didn't see a Stoneforge Mystic. I think if he's playing some, he's playing like two, so I don't want to overboard for it. Sneep. This hand actually has a pretty good curve. Oh man, I just want to do that. I was just going to play Pile Driver, but I can always play Pile Driver next turn. And he's just sitting there with like Bolt mana, so. I don't think he's playing Stifle, so I don't think this waste matters. Or the timing of it, rather. But you should usually waste on their upkeep. So then if they have a way of stopping the Wasteland effect, like say they have a Stifle, then they're using their mana on their turn. Or as Rich Hagon would call it, their mana. I wish I could do a British accent. I was in a play in college where we did Irish accents. That was a lot of fun. Irish. By the Bog of Cats. It was a fine play. I like didn't practice it at all after the play though. You kind of lose it. Kind of like a foreign language. Like you take so many years of a language in high school, and then you never practice it again, so you forget all of it. All right. Yes. Redundant vial A. Actually, seems like he's in fine shape. We're missing the goblins that actually let us win the game. With card advantage, cards like Matron and Ringleader and stuff. They seem kind of important. I guess the Siege Gang Commander is real good. Not good against Supreme Verdict, but good against the rest of his deck. And Violing in Krenko at his end of turn is alright as well. Oh man, what if we just didn't do anything with this for a few turns and got the vial up to like 3 and 4, and then we go end of turn vial and Krenko, and then he has to like use a removal spell on his end of turn, and then we in response vial and Warchief get value. Oh man, I'm not going to do that because I can just get value from my Siege Gang Commander by ticking this vial up to 5, but that would be savage, right? No, he has a thing. Looks like Snapcast Swords. Actually, he probably wants to Snapcast Blue Elemental Blast it. Yeah, so that he can save the Swords to Plowshares for Pile Driver with a future Snapcaster Mage. Aether Vial up to 5. He probably knows what that means. I actually don't want to throw the Warchief into the Snapcaster for a few points of damage. I'm just going to attack. Cool. So our best draws are like Matron and Ringleader, not close. Pretty glad he did this, because I was going to end of turn throw a goblin as Snapcaster. So this way I get to sacrifice the guy that was going to die to the Hydro Blast anyway. A little bit better value. Yeah, we're never taking that one up, so... So he kind of needs a spot removal for the pile driver here. Or I think he just dies, right? It's a lot of damage. 4 times 2 is 8. Okay, he goes to 2. Sure. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Yeah. Cool. Got me. I won the match.
That was kind of interesting because we didn't actually play any of the card advantage goblins except for Siege Gang. But I guess he just never found an answer to the pile driver. There's too much damage to deal with. The Supreme Verdict here would have been really good, but then we've got enough like haste creatures that just the act of getting him down to 2 life is probably good for us because we have so many uncounterable haste creatures. I'm guessing that his hand at the end there was like a couple, either like Jace or some counter magic that just didn't do anything against Vial plus Cavern. So go us. On round 2. See you guys there.